Savage Messiah began life as a series of 11 zines self-published by the British artist and author Laura Grace Ford, also known as Laura Oldfield Ford, between 2005 and 2009. In 2011, the entire collection was brought out as a book by Verso. It consists of texts in courier font, plus black and white photos, mainly of rundown locations in Greater London, plus drawn portraits. Like many zines, it looks as if it's been assembled with glue and scissors, then photocopied and stapled for distribution. Ford's subject is the gentrification of large parts of London under the new Labour governments of Tony Blair and Gordon Brown, and the retreat of undesirable marginalised groups and individuals, which was part of that process. Her account includes biographical and autobiographical episodes, pen portraits of friends, acquaintances and strangers, and lyrical descriptions of places and events. Time frames are conflated. What looks at first like an exclusive focus on the years 2005 to 2009 turns out on closer examination to be a deeper critique of a more permanent process of urban so-called renewal. The book's overriding theme is authenticity, specifically the kind the Sex Pistols claimed for themselves when in 1977 they sang "We Mean It, Man." It looks, and is clearly intended to look, like the zine equivalent of an early British punk band. The book's dystopian visual effects and Ford's disjointed radical prose are hedged round with quotations from a wide variety of intellectuals, from J.G. Ballard to George Simmel. The erudition, the proficiency of the writing, and the stream of consciousness wandering across a city can occasionally put the reader in mind of Ulysses. If I have one criticism, it has to do with the introduction, or rather introductions, one ostensibly a preface by Grail Marcus, the other a lengthier contribution by Mark Fisher. Somewhere along the line, I'd like to have known more about the zine's history. How was it physically produced? How was it distributed? What was the usual print run? Was there a list of subscribers, or was it sold on the street? Who bought it? What did they expect to get out of it? How did it ever come to the attention of a traditional publisher? More trivially, how much can an original zine be expected to fetch on eBay nowadays? In the end, urban renewal is an everlasting process. There's never enough money to do everything, and ordinary people keep getting in the way. Not to mention, of course, that when it's successful, it so often benefits only the already wealthy. As if to confirm that, in 2018, the author produced a 12th issue of Savage Messiah. What prompted her to come back after a nearly 10-year absence? Partly the Grenfell Tower fire. Enough said.